On Tonight with Al Kasim, Kingdom Company has seen its most solid corruption in the past 20 years of their operation. This is what happened.
It's Ali, fabulous, he, Ali Ababa. Can you flex, show some respect, now the Monday. Now try your best to stay calm, brush up your Sunday salon, then come and meet his spectacular coterie. Prince Ali, mighty is he, Ali Ababa. Strong as 10 regular men, definitely.
He sees the galloping hordes,
100 bad guys with swords,
who sent those goons to their lord,
my Prince Ali.
Who is the new guy out there? Where's my old accountant?
Oh, your pet assistant? I just fired him, he's too inefficient. I hired someone new, he's Aladdin.
Just because your father is the CEO of the company doesn't give you the right to bring in anyone from the street. I am the supreme advisor of this company. You have to consult me first.
Well, if you are the supreme advisor, I am the supreme HR manager. I hire and fire as I wish.
As you wish.
Welcome to modern Agrabah, where friendly bargaining in the street market has evolved into a cutthroat world of office politics. And ethical issues take on an entirely different playing field. As a new accountant, Aladdin questioned the discrepancy in the previous report. But what he got was a mere gaze of disapproval.
It's okay. I think if you're busy, I'll come back later. Sorry.
I will show you what ethic is under my control.
Wow, Aladdin, you working so hard. Why don't you just relax, like some time, like some snack and chit chat.
It's okay. It's okay. Thanks. Go back to your work.
Okay, enough. I'm going back to my work. Don't disturb me, okay? Because I have to finish my important mission, which is to save the princess.
Okay, don't disturb me also. Company, Aladdin here.
Aladdin, would you like to go for a drink?
Abu!
Oh, so sorry!
Abu, stop disturbing me!
Who is Abu?
Huh?
Come to my room now.
Okay, Aladdin. Rule number one. When I give you a report, you have to do exactly what I tell you to do. No question asked. Rule number two. If you fail to follow rule number one, you know what I can do to you. Now, finish all this report and hand it to me by Monday.
But tomorrow is Sunday.
Go.
The deeper Aladdin dipped into the accounting documents, the more tremendously his suspicions piled up against Jafar. Till one moment, those secrets were unearthed.
Don't worry, everything is under my control. Just keep our business a secret and keep it under my control. Ali, what are you doing? I'm happy. I'm sure you keep everything hidden to yourself. I promise you a good life in Kingdom's company.
Yes.
Otherwise, don't regret.
What you see, it's the second glance that ties your hands as darkness pulls the strings. Be careful, little feet, where you go, for it's the little feet behind you that are sure to follow. It's a slow fade when you give yourself away. It's a slow fade when black and white turn to gray and thoughts invade. Choices are made, a price will be paid when you give yourself away. People never crumble in a day.
Some of the stuff.
Hey, anyone or anything troubling you?
I don't know how to say this, but...
Well, remember to stand firm in what you believe in. Just do what you think is right, and if you happen to be presented with different choices, no one can stop you from doing what you want to do. So ultimately, the choice is still yours. I have faith in you.
I wish I had the courage to choose what's right.
Oh dear, I can give you 3 wishes, but no, I can't give you courage. Use your head and ask Aladdin.
Aladdin?
With his newfound courage, Aladdin revealed to Jasmine the secret plans of Jafar. Together they vowed to uncover the fraud, the unethical deeds that Jafar had committed. And as they searched through piles of files, not only the evidence grew, but their connection grew deeper. Till one day...
Well, thank you everyone for taking care of the company while I'm away.
But there, I have something to tell you.
With the evidence they found, Aladdin and Jasmine were able to convince Sultan, and Jafar was soon arrested. And in this faraway land of modern Agrabah, a whole new world begins to emerge.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide?
Thanks to the courage and ethical conduct of Aladdin, Kingdom Company has been saved. Now, let me bring you to an interview conducted by my colleague.
Hi, I'm with Mr. Alvin Ong, the Vice President of Clarendon Law Singapore. It's a pleasure to have you here with me today.
The pleasure is all mine.
So, what are the ethical issues that you face in your office?
Well, there are many ethical challenges these days in many organizations, and I think one of the biggest challenges is office politics. And people tend to use their own assigned powers to gain advantages beyond their legitimate powers and authority.
As you move up the hierarchy, do you feel an increasing pressure to compromise ethical values for personal interests?
Yes, I think as a person moves up the corporate ladder, there tends to be a temptation to use their authority for personal gain. I think this is a very subjective and individual question, like how strong is the person's will to uphold his own principle.
Okay, thanks for the time.
You're welcome.
Now let's welcome our guest of the day, industrial analyst from Agrabah, to share with us their valuable insights. So what's your view on this?
Well, I think this is sending out a lamb to awaken the other company in the business world. You never know who's going to be the second Jafar. It's a fraudulent act that can happen in every corner of the workplace. At the end of the day, it all comes down to whether the voice of morale can be amplified enough to speak up against malpractice.
Yes, in fact, what we just saw between Aladdin and Jafar happened a few years ago in WorldCom and Enron. In WorldCom especially, the Vice President of Internal Audit, Cynthia Cooper, actually saw what Scott Sullivan did. He's a CFO, and she did not relish her role as a whistleblower, but she took courage and she reported his fraudulent acts, and her story was reported in the Time magazine as the whistleblowers of the year at that time.
I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over sideways and under.
Thank you for coming tonight and sharing your valuable insight. Thank you for watching, and good night.
A new world, a new fantastic point of view.
No, I don't want to be another Jafar.
That's because your father is
a... And tonight with Al Kashim, Kingdom Company has seen its most corrupted...
And rule number two, if you fail to fulfill rule number one, you have to...
No. Is it recording?
Are you recording?
I'm just stopping, I'm sorry.